Good day, learners! I am Teacher Nathan, your teacher for today's lesson. We are on the fourth week of quarter 2 here in English 3. We will use the Pivot 4A learner's material from DepEd Region 4A Calabarzon. Our lesson for today is all about consonant digraphs, CH and SH. And for today's objective, at the end of the lesson, you are expected to read words, phrases, sentences, and short stories consisting of words with consonant digraph, CH and SH, and other words previously studied. Here are our content standard, performance standard, and the most essential learning competencies. Before we discuss our main topic today, let us review first how words are formed. Can you still remember the differences between words and phrases? When we say words, these are letters combined together. It may vary in terms of length and number of letters. What about phrases? When we say phrase, these are formed by combining words together. These phrases may provide descriptions or ideas about particular subject. Let us identify the following if it is a word or a phrase. Friend. That is a word. How about delicious cake? This one is a phrase. Number 3, cake. Cake is a word. Number 4, beautiful dress. This one is an example of phrase. And dress. Dress is a word. And let us discuss our lesson for today. It is all about consonant digraphs, CH and SH. Let's read the names of the picture given on your screen. That one is chair. Chair. Cheese. Cheese. Chalk. Chalk. Shell, shell. Sheep, sheep. Shoes, shoes. What is a consonant digraph CH and SH? These are composed of two adjacent consonant sounds that produce one unique sound. Common examples of consonant digraphs include CH and SH. These consonant digraphs represent unique sounds, especially when used in words. Digraph CH. Examples: church, chocolate, chicken. Church, chocolate, chicken. March, starch, beach. March, starch, beach. Shop, shop, shampoo. Shark, shop, shampoo, shark. Wash, cash, squash. Wash, cash, squash. Is everything clear so far? And to help us identify that you understand the digraph CH and SH, kindly get your pen and paper and let us answer the following activity. Are you ready? Let's go! Read the passage below and underline the words with consonant digraph CH and SH. Chad sat down in his new blue chair. Should I have soup for dinner? Chad thought to himself. Why not? Chad chuckled. He got up and walked to his kitchen. This shall be good, he thought to himself. And now let us check if your answers are correct. We have Chad, chair, should, Chud, Chud again, chuckled, kitchen, and shawl. Those are consonant digraph CH and SH. Kids, you did a great job. I know you were able to get a perfect score in our activity. Congratulations! For learning task number 2, on your answer sheet or pad paper, copy and read the words, then underline the consonant digraph CH and SH. We have check, chase, dish, shampoo, shark, sheet, shovel, chain, chance, and squash. Have you identified the consonant digraphs in the words? Let's check. We have check, chase, dish, shampoo, shark, sheet, shovel, chain, chance, and squash. And for your learning task number 3, you copy and read the phrases below, then underline the consonant digraphs CH and SH. We have cheerful churchmen, sheep, shit, and shop, shiny shoes, Shelton's shell, rich child, shaping the shoreline, chilling cheese, cheesy chicken, shampoo and cash, chips for lunch. Let's check if you underlined the correct digraphs in these phrases. We have Do you got the same answer? Wow, that's right. Kids, you did a great job. I know you were able to get a perfect score in our activity. Now, for your homework, get your self-learning module in English and you may start answering page 17, letter A. Thank you for listening, dear learners. I am Teacher Nathan. Always remember, learning is a continuous process. It is not a competition. You may feel the pressure and difficulty while having our blended classes. But once you put your heart and mind in it, you will surely adapt to the new normal of education. And it will be a better and great one. Again, I am Teacher Nathan. Until next time, happy learning!